Dale, thank you. We want to update you now on that breaking news that we had out of Asheville this morning, a fire at an apartment complex.
Yeah, and if I understand correctly, do we have Sean Mazzarella live by internet this morning? Sean, if you can hear us, tell us what you know.
Gordon, Beth, good morning. I'm at the Turtle Creek Apartments in Asheville. If you look behind me, you can see some of the firefighters and the fire trucks moving around. Back further there is the building that actually caught on fire. What I'm told would happen is around 2 o'clock this morning, the 911 call came in that there was a fire at this apartment complex. The first firefighters on the scene here reported seeing heavy smoke and fire coming from one of the buildings. They started to attack the fire, but they also had a rescue to make. There were three people that were trapped in the burning building, and they had to get them out. We're told they were successful, and those people were not hurt. Then the issue came of putting the fire out. It took an hour and 15 minutes to mark this fire under control, meaning it was no longer a threat of spreading. But as you can see, there's still a ladder back there. There are still firefighters moving around. They are watching this for the last 4 hours, making sure that no hot spots spread, because what we're told happened is that the fire spread through the attic, so it damaged several apartments. I just spoke to the Red Cross, who's at the scene assisting these families. The Red Cross spokesperson tells me that there were 15 to 30 apartments that were damaged. So that means 15 to 30 people are being displaced. So right now, at a clubhouse just off to my left, right now they're sleeping on cots, they're getting food, they're getting clothing. They're doing what the Red Cross does, and they're helping these families who have just lost a lot of their belongings. So we're going to update you throughout the morning with this story as we get to talk to the firefighters who are now wrapping up here at the scene, and we'll also let you know how those families are doing.